Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to go over all the products that are my favorites up until now for 2020. So we are like 6.5-ish months into 2020 now. I have been started to try a lot of products in these last 6 months, and a few of them really stood out. So I want to share with you which products are my faves up until now. I didn't include any fills, just the faves. I want to keep it positive today. I just have some favorites. Also, I have been doing this favorites and fails videos of, I think, a few months now. And what I am going to do, instead of doing them every month, I'm going to do them quarterly, because I have been noticing that I don't have enough products every month that I've tried out to really say this is my new favorite. So that's just a household keeping like announcement. And without further ado, let's just jump into the video. Let me show you what are the products that have been top-notch up until now. Before I jump into the video, if you're new here, hi, welcome. My name is Anne Chris and I love, love, love to play with colorful makeup, but I always try to keep my looks a little bit more elegant, classy and wearable. I also love to try out new makeup products. I have been for years, especially from indie brands and mid to higher end brands. And I'm here to tell you which products I think are good and which ones are not worth your time and money. If you want to play a little bit more with color, but you don't really know how to keep it a little bit more wearable, and if you want to know the best products for those looks, then please consider subscribing. I upload 2 to 3 times a week, so there's always something fun to watch, and I would love to have you here and see you back in my comment section chatting about beautiful makeup. All right, I am going to start off with the basics. I'm going to start off with primers. I have been trying or using this Smashbox Minimize Pores Primers for the last 6 months, and this is one of my favorites. But I think it is actually my favorite product. It is stunning. It is better than the Benefit Poreless Primer. Consistency-wise, it's kind of the same, but this one doesn't peel up as much and it really fills up my pores. I do have some deeper pores up my nose, so I really need some pore-filling primer before I put on some foundation, because otherwise it looks weird. And this is a beautiful product for that. Also, I have been trying this e.l.f. Porous Putty Primer, and this is a primer I have been reaching for a lot as well. I have to say, this one, if it's really warm, I don't really like to use this, because it's a little bit more emollient than the Smashbox one. It went flying. Than the Smashbox one. So this is one I really prefer to use when it's a little bit colder outside, and it's summer now, so it's really like sticky. And then I don't really like this one because it tends to break up my makeup when it's a little bit warmer. But if I am not too warm, if it's like not 30 degrees outside and it's Celsius, you know, for reference Celsius, then this is a very nice primer. It really smooths out my skin. It makes my makeup look very nice, very smooth, and it does prolong the wear, but not if it's too warm. So this is a favorite as well for me. Then I'm going into eye primers. I have 2 new favorites. This is the Anastasia eye primer base for the eyes. This is slightly lighter, almost white. It's not exactly white, but almost white. And I love this primer because it makes color stand out very nicely. It blends away it hides my discoloration on my eyes and the veins and stuff like that. And it's because it's so light, colorful makeup really shows up on this little base. And what I really love about it is it's almost self-setting. I always set my eyeshadow base a little bit because I don't like it to be too sticky. So it's like more of a habit than really necessary, because this one is almost self-setting. So you can practically work over it once it's set and then it's done. So this is really nice. And also the Sigma eyeshadow base primer, I have it in this shade Ignite. It's like more of a closer to my skin tone. And I do really love this as well because if you look at the formula, it's a little bit like the Paint Pot from MAC, but it dries down a little bit more. So it's a little bit more self-setting. And that is what I really love about it. I also love that it's in a stick form. So it doesn't really, I don't have to go with a brush in there. I just can tap it out with my finger. And I really, really, really enjoy that for it. Both of those primers really make my eyeshadows last longer. So that is a good thing as well. Then some more base products. I'm going to start off with more of a primer product. This is the Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector. If you have seen my 5 Pro MUA Makeup Tips video, I will link it up there. Then you see that I have quite dark under eyes and I really need something to brighten them, lift them up a little bit more because they're quite sunken. And as you can see, they have like a darkness there. So I really need to work with some color correcting, and this is a very nice product for that. It's very sticky, so it holds on to your concealer as well. So that is something I really like. And yeah, I am really, really blown away by this product. I love it. Then I have two concealers I have been using a lot. This is the ColourPop Pretty Fresh, the Hyaluronic Creamy Concealer. I am not really a drugstore type of person, but I really like ColourPop's products if they are really affordable and if they're good quality. I don't really think just being affordable is enough. It needs to be good quality. And what I love about this one is that it's the consistency is not too drying for my under eye. I can just powder it. It's fine. It's great. It does its job. It has enough coverage for my darker circles. And I do love the formula because it's not drying. And I'm 37, so I have quite crepey textured under eyes. And this doesn't settle into lines as much as others do. And what I think is most important, that it doesn't age my under eye. So this is a very nice product, and I can practically say the same for this Radiant Lift Long Lasting and Radiant Concealer from Max Factor. Also a drugstore product, but this is more of like a luxury drugstore, like Milani Physicians Formula. Max Factor is a little bit more expensive, and I think it really shows in the products. This is a very nice under eye concealer. It is the same really with the Fresh Wear. It doesn't age my under eyes. It has enough coverage, but it feels really hydrating under the skin. I can powder it very nicely without it looking too cakey. So I really do enjoy this product as well. This is in the shade 02 Light. Then I'm going a little bit more in like the priming and setting category. And this is a new setting spray I've been trying from Pixi. It's the Hydrating Milky Mist. I'm wearing it today and I really, really love it because my top favorite is always MAC Fix Plus when it comes to finishing your skin, making it look less powdery. So that is really my big favorite, but this one is very nice as well. For me, this product is more expensive than the Fix Plus. So for me, it's not like this is a, you know, a dupe type of product, but I know Pixi in America is a lot cheaper than it is in Holland, so maybe this could be a dupe for MAC Fix Plus. Let me know down below if it is more or less expensive in your country than the MAC Fix Plus. Why I like it so much is because it has the same effect as the MAC Fix Plus on my skin. I have normal to drier skin, and I really love the effect this gives. It's like melts your makeup into your skin. It has very soft mister. It doesn't disrupt anything when it comes to your makeup. So that is why I really love this product. Then I'm going into some blushes, highlighters, and bronzers. And I have been stocking up on those quite a lot this year, or this last 6 months, and I have a few favorites. So I'm going to start off with bronzer. The first one is the Ofra and Samantha March collaboration. It's this one. It's the River Bronzer, and it has a shimmery side and it has a matte side, and I'm wearing it today. What I really love about this bronzer is that it has this warm bronze without going too orange on my skin, and I have that problem a lot. I have to be very careful not to make the, I don't know why it is, because I have a neutral to yellow undertone, like warm undertone, not necessarily cool or redness, but somehow a lot of bronzers can look very red on me. This one doesn't. I really love it, and I love the fact that you can either go for the matte side, or you can go for the shimmer side, or just shimmer side, or you can just mix the two. I always mix them. It's easier and I love the effect it gives on my skin. It makes it a little bit more glowy. It gives it a little bit more dimension. So I am really loving this bronzer. The other bronzer I keep reaching for is this Jouer one. This is the Sun Swept bronzer. And there goes the film. You have Sun Light, that's the very light one, and the Sun Tan one. Well, this is Sunlight and this is Suntan, I would say. But you have Sunlight and Suntan. This is the lighter shade in their range and it's fine for me. I must say, I have a little bit of a tan right now, so I can only use the darker one. The lighter one does show up on me when my skin is a little bit lighter than it is right now. But I really love the consistency. It blends out like a dream. It has this cooler toned look, but it really bronzes up my face without it getting too orange or too red. And yeah, it's just a stunning product. I love the packaging. Jouer has such cute packaging. So this is a very, very big favorite for me over the last 6 months as well. When it comes to blushes, I also really love that collaboration with Ofra and Samantha March. This is the Chick Lit Blush Duo. And what I like about this one is the tone. It has a very dark mauve-y tone, and I must say you have to, also with the bronzer and with the highlight that is coming up, but also with this blush, you have to go in carefully. Don't have a heavy hand, because it shows up, it's there, it's attending the party. So you have to be careful not to go too hard or too heavy-handed with this one. I have noticed that I can blend it out when I'm buffing my face. I always buff my face. You can blend it out very beautifully and it looks nice, but it's just, you know, it's always easier to add a product than take it off. So just be careful. But the tone is so flattering. It's so stunning. I love this. And again, there's a shimmery and a matte side. And what I love about the shimmer side is also really nice, because it gives dimension to the skin without it being too glittery or emphasizing texture. So I really love that. And then I have the Cover FX blush. This is the soft peach one, and I have been wanting this for a very long time, and it showed up on Beauty Base, so I took the plunge. They're not cheap, but I feel, for me, it's worth the money, because this is a very nice formula. It picks up beautifully. You can blend it out very nicely. This side I really use as a highlight, because I feel that it has a little bit too much of a shimmer to put it on the apples of my cheek. So that is a thing. That is a thing. But I really do love the shade. I do love the texture and the formula. It shows up. It blends out very beautifully. And they are very complementary to each other. And the packaging feels so nice. It's this like almost velvety plastic feeling like NARS can have. It's a very, very beautiful product and a very beautiful packaging. The next one is the Ambient Lighting Blush in Dim Infusion. And this is really one of those products a YouTuber made me buy. And if you can guess, leave me down in the comments who you think it is. But leave me a comment down below if you guessed it. This is a beautiful blush. I'm wearing it today. If you see this, you're like, girl, that wouldn't show up. It's so light. It does look very light, but it does show up. And it shows up in the most natural, flattering way. It has a bit of a shimmer because of those little veins in there. You have a bit of a shimmer. But again, the same as with the Ofra and Samantha March collab. It gives you dimension rather than emphasizing texture or making your face a shimmering mess. So this is since I got it, I have been reaching for it almost every day, unless I have to use my Shop My Stash and my Project Pan products. But I am totally head over heels in love with this blush. It's stunning. Then I have three highlighters. The first one, you guessed it, it's the Ofra and Samantha March collab. This is the Start Inspired highlight. This is a very bold highlighter. You have to be extremely careful when you are not someone who likes that blinding highlight, who wants to shine from the high heavens. But I must say, if you use a very light hand and you buff it in, it's the most stunning wet look you can ever get. I have never expected to love a highlighter that is so out there, because I'm going to show you two more that are really more that glow from within type of highlight. One with a bit of a twist and the other one really that glow from within. But I love that highlighter. It's stunning. It gives the most stunning effect when you buff it in. Highly suggest that. The other one I really love is this 50-50 highlighter in blushing pink. I have used this in my shop, my stash, I think 1 or 2 months ago, and I am wearing it today. And what, as you can see, it gives this like stunning glow from within, almost that wet look, but it also has this bit of a pink shift without it looking too bold. So this is, I think, a stunning highlighter if you want to play a little bit more with color, but you don't really dare to have like a green or very yellow highlighter on your face, but you want something fun. This is stunning, stunning. It's a Dutch indie brand. You can just order from their site. They ship internationally, so please try them out. I love that highlighter. Their eyeshadows are thebomb.com as well, but that highlighter, stunning, stunning. Then I have this infinity highlighter from Linda Hallebaut. She has, I think it's in the shade Vertigo, but I don't really know for sure. She had this highlighter palette, I remember. I think it's a highlighter palette, and this one shade had everybody raving, please get this out in like a single, because if it, you know, you go through it very quickly because it is so stunning, and it totally is. If you want a highlighter that is truly that glow from within, it's not too harsh, it's not emphasizing texture, it's not this high wave of highlight on your face, then this is really the one to go for, because it is the most beautiful effect on the face. It gives the most stunning, stunning glow without, you know, looking too bold and without looking, you know, like a hot mess or sweaty or anything like that. This is really a very natural highlighter and I love it. Then I am going to go into some brow products. There are two brow products I have been reaching for the last 6 months without really thinking about it. And the first one is this Catrice Brow Colors in the shade, I can't really find the shade, but it's like a grayish, taupe-ish type of shade. And I am usually not someone who really loves like drugstore products, but I did a full face of Catrice products, I think almost a year back or longer than a year back, and I found this lately. And I was like, you know, let's just start using it because I have it and it would be a waste if I don't use it. It's a stunning product, I must say. The first time I used this, it has this very small wand and the color is really, really, really spot on for me. What I didn't like about it at first was that the formula was really wet, so I had a lot of excess product in my brow hairs, but because it has been a year, it dried up a little bit and it's perfect now, so I really do adore it. And then something like that, that is a little bit more expensive and I think gives you a little bit more than the Catrice does, is this Dip Brow, I think it's a Dip Brow Gel. The Dip Brow Gel in the shade Taupe. It's a mini from Anastasia Beverly Hills. I just ordered it with one of the orders I did for some eyeshadow palettes. And I ordered this one because I just wanted to try it. So that is why I got it. And I must say, I think this is one of the most easy products ever. If I don't feel like really doing my eyebrows with a bit of powder or with a pencil, then I just use this. It has a little bit more coverage than and color than the Catrice one. And it is just enough. And I love it. It's a little bit bigger than the Catrice one, as you can see. But the formula is a little bit more drier than the Catrice one, so it does really coat your hairs and make your eyebrows look fuller without having to hassle a lot with like pencils and powders and stuff like that, or pomade, whatever is your preferred way of doing your brows. I must say, I have quite okay brows naturally, so for me this is a beautiful product. I don't know if you are used to drawing in like hair like strokes and stuff like that, if this would be perfect for you, but I really love it. Both of them have quite okay staying power, but this one is better. The Anastasia one is better. That really sticks on and stays on all day. Then I have one little thing before I go into eyeshadows, and that is this little puff type of product. I got this, I think it's from the brand Glove. I got one packet with three of these in there. These are these reusable cotton round thingies, but I don't use it for that. I've used it once or twice to try to take off my makeup. I didn't like it because it has this like very big seam, so I didn't really, really like it. The texture is not really that great for it either, so I thought maybe I should use this as a powder puff because it's extremely soft and it's stunning for that. It gives this like very airbrushed effect when I use this little pad with my powder to powder down my face instead of a brush. I love it. It's a very stunning product for that. All right, and then my last category, I have some eyeshadows I want to share with you that I think are the bomb.com. And I want to start off with, again, 50-50 makeup. I have been dabbling in some loose pigments lately. A few months ago, 50-50 added some loose pigments to their range, and I didn't really use that much loose pigments because I think they're always a little bit messy. They don't really stick to the eye very well. They're not that easy to work with. These are stunning, and I love the effect these ones give. They are so easy to work with. They are opaque, they have beautiful shifts, and I really, really love them. So you have to really check out 50-50 makeup. They make the best stuff. Then I also have a eyeshadow palette that is one of my favorites that they came out with this year. And that is this one. It's the Spring Palette. I did a video, I think, only on my Instagram. I will link my Instagram down below. But I did a look with this one on my Instagram. I don't think I did an eyeshadow or a video about it. But this is a stunning palette. The quality is top notch. The eyeshadows blend out like a dream. The shimmers are stunning. They are really that one swipe and they're on. And I love this palette. I think the color story is so cute, so fun. So summery, of course, very spring, but also very well suited for summer. And this is one of the favorites that I have gotten in the last 6 months. Then I have another indie brand, Davina Cosmetics, and I got their Exploders collection a few months ago. And I have been dipping into these little shades a lot lately. I am someone, I do love the effect it gives when you swatch a duo or a trichrome, but I don't always love them on my eyes because I think they can look a little bit messy. But these are so stunning because they have like that shift. These are just a few swatches. They have a bit of a shift to make them interesting, but it's not that pronounced. So it's not messy. You get like a color and you get a bit of dimension, but it's not too messy. So I have been loving these Exploder shades. Very stunning. Davina Cosmetics makes some stunning stuff, but I love these a lot. Then I have another indie brand. This is the Nabla Wild Berry palette. It's in the Cutie collection. They released 3 new Cutie palettes and I have 2. I made a video about them. I will link it up here in the cards. But this is my favorite. This is such a stunning color story. Very unique colors. This is such a unique color. It's so stunning. And you can make a very nice sultry burgundy eye with this. You go sultry very fast with this one. So be warned, but I love the color story. I love the quality of the matte shades. I love the quality of the shimmers. It's so stunning. And it has only 6 shadows. I love that. I love that you can make a palette that is this cohesive, that you can make several looks out of, but it's only 6 shades. I love that. So this is one of my favorites as well. Then more into mainstream. This is a big, big, big surprise for me. This is the Carly Bible palette. I got it late last year, but I only started to really dig into this one when I put it in my Shop My Stash. And this is one of the hidden gems of Anastasia Beverly Hills. I must say, it is such a shame this didn't get the attention and time it deserved to get, because it is a stunning palette. I never expected it would be this versatile, but it is very versatile. You can go neutral, you can go colorful, but it's always subdued, very elegant, very pretty, cutesy. I love it. It's such a stunning palette. The quality is outstanding. It's just Anastasia quality, so it's really beautiful. This is really a hidden gem for this. It's not technically this year because it released last year, but it's one of the palette I have been enjoying so much this last 6 months. And this is the last item I have. Yes, this is the last item I have. And this is the Sigma Corderosa palette. When I first saw this, I do this Will I Buy It series, and when I first saw this, I was like, ooh, because it was very, very orangey terracotta on the picture. So I was like, ooh, I need to get that because I love those types of shades. Then I saw some other pictures, then I saw some reviews showing up, and there was a lot more dimension to this palette than I thought at first, and I was a little bit like, am I going to love it? Yes, there's burgundy in there, but I already had the Nabla palette, so I was like, do I need it? Do I need it? Okay, I didn't need it, but girl, am I glad that I got this. I love it. The shadows are outstanding quality. All of these mattes blend like a dream. You have these like topper shades that are stunning, but you also have these like more shimmer, and you have somewhat of a satin, a true satin shade in here. The colors are so stunning. They really complement each other. You can really combine any of these colors and they look stunning together. So I am really glad that I got this. I didn't get ready with me with this palette. I will link that up in the cards as well. But I love it. I love the palette. Okay, guys. These were all the stuffs. I was like, okay, I went through my collection and I pulled stuff like, oh yeah, this one, ooh, and that one, oh, I love this one. And I really narrowed it down to a few categories. I didn't have anything in every category because, for example, mascaras. I have mascaras, a lot of mascaras, but it's also always the Monsieur Big that is still my favorite, so no changes there. But the rest were like, yeah, I want to share this with you. These are products I really love and think are worth your money and your time. Okay, guys, that was it from me today. I really am very curious. Are there any products you saw in this video today that are favorite status for you as well? Or are there some products where you're like, girl, I don't get why you love this. Leave me a comment down below. I would love to know. I would love to chat some makeup with you. So please do. I hope you liked what you saw today. Thank you so much for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked what you saw, and please subscribe so I can see you in my next one. Bye.